ARES Commander offers us tools to model in 3D faster. Among them, push and pull stands out. Let's see how it works with these figures. In the first place, push and pull with a simple and closed form will work as if it were the extrude command, where we simply indicate a height and press enter. Let's change the shading mode. Of course, the objects can have their own color, or acquire the color of the layer in which they were created. Now observe how push and pull works in this area. We will see that we can approach an entity, and in this case with push and pull, we get a cylinder, because we've started from a circle, just like in the previous figure. Or we can position the pointer in an inner zone where push and pull recognizes that there are closed inner forms, which generates holes directly on the remaining solid. The truth is that push and pull allows us to extrude from the face of an object. For example, in this case, if we want to add more height to the object created previously, we can do it by selecting the face and extrude it, in the same way that you would do it as the extrude command with the surface option. In addition, we can also extrude it downwards, indicating it on the screen or writing a value that can be positive or negative, depending on the position of the pointer with respect to the face we wish to extrude. In this case, I have the mouse over the selected face, and that's why we're going to write a negative value. In this way, the piece loses height. Let's try this form in I, created with a closed polyline. Using push and pull, we extruded it and we obtained a shape similar to a pillar or metal beam. But in addition, we can extrude any of their faces. In this other example, where we have an open polyline of several segments and an arc, by using push and pull, we get meshes. If we change the display mode, we can check that the meshes have faces that, by the way, we can vary from the properties palette. Now, let's hollow out this metal pillar. To do this, taking advantage of the characteristics of the Dynamic CCS, we go to the circle command, simply with the C key and pressing enter. By bringing the pointer closer to that face, we can see how ARES Commander detects it and positions the CCS in it. We click on it to indicate the center of the circle and then its radius. Now, pay attention. Using push and pull, we will create an extrusion on the circle that generates a hole directly, avoiding the process of having to extrude the form to then use the Boolean Substract operation. Let's go back in this last step and go to a right view. We copy the circle along the pillar. Once again, with push and pull, we're going to generate a new extrusion, only this time we're going to select the Expecia zone with respect to those circles, generating an extrusion that leaves out the shape of the circles, creating a small relief. To learn more about ARES Commander and the tools it offers to model in 3D, be sure to visit the extensive help offered by the programme.